Alright, we're getting ready to get things started here. Hope everyone's having a terrific Tuesday night so far. Oh, today was exhausting. Surprisingly, no, not as exhausting as yesterday. So, obviously, I apologize for there being no Mountain Blade Monday stream. Monday this week was just like I kind of explained that on my Twitter, but we had to unload a double truck at work yesterday. We had to unload two trucks in a row, so yeah, that kind of killed me. And tonight it was also two trucks that we had to unload, but it wasn't too bad, which is weird to say, especially since I was throwing the second truck. I don't know. I'm not feeling like as exhausted as I probably should be, but I don't know. I guess I just also didn't want to hold you guys off 2 days in a row again. And on top of that, I got some nice drinks to hold me over. I got me a nice blue raspberry slushy that I'm currently going through and trying not to get a brain freeze from. And I got a nice bottle of Pepsi. So I'm set for the remainder of the stream, basically. there really isn't a whole lot of gaming news to really talk about. I mean, there's some Helldivers 2 stuff. Like, I know they revealed the APC is a new stratagem that we're getting, basically an armored vehicle. I'm excited for that. And, the other thing that was revealed, I guess, recently was that, the automatons are getting a new, enemy type. They're basically AT-ATs from Star Wars, so that's fun. As if the tanks and all that were, as if the tanks and the Hulks were, you know, weren't enough. They want to torture us more with those four-legged beasts that they plan on unveiling. Oh, fuck. I'm so exhausted from today. But we're going to persevere. And also, you know, that mixture of exhaustion and frustration really makes me want to kill some shit. And given tonight we're continuing God of War, you know, it's a good game to do that kind of stuff. Don't take it out on people IRL. Take it out on fictional enemies in a video game, which is what we're doing. Greek mythological creatures. We talking minotaurs, gorgons, undead soldiers, whatever, harpies. So yeah. Last part, we end up leaving Athens. We went through the Desert of Lost Souls. We climbed on top of Kronos the Titan, because he has been tortured and tormented to basically carry Pandora's temple on his back through the desert. So we climbed onto Kronos. We spent 3 days climbing the temple. We're in Pandora's temple now. We completed the challenge of Atlas. We also got Artemis's blade, the blade of Artemis. This giant greatsword, really fun stuff to use. Yeah, we got one of the heads of the son of Pathos Verdes. And I think all that we have left in the temple, at least for the first part of it, is we have the challenge of Poseidon, which we need to do next. And then after the challenge of Poseidon is the challenge of Hades, and then that's when we make our way up. I think that's how it is for today. Which, if we're heading up Challenge of Hades tonight, then we're about to do a really, really fun boss fight. But yeah, we're gonna go ahead and get shit started here. But you know how it is, ladies and gentlemen. You know how it is. I gotta give a shout out to Night Ride FM, 24/7 Synthwave Radio. They have an app on Android devices, as well as a website that you can go on called nightride.fm. They also have a Discord server that you can join as well, so you get any and all updates and releases regarding any and all things synthwave. On both the website and the app, you can switch between other radio stations that play some genres of synthwave that they've partnered up with. So they got stuff from the top down. They got chill synth, data wave, space synth, dark synth, horror synth, and EBSM. And if you are a streamer, they have what is called the Stream Free Archive. It is basically a big old playlist of songs that they have that are stream free. I have used it in the past. I haven't gotten VOD muted on the streams I have used it on. So it does work. And on top of that, you just also get to enjoy and discover a lot of amazing artists like King Stephen, which is an actual artist name, by the way. Really great stuff, honestly. You got Aviators, you got Scandroid, you got Technomage, Jay Diggs, Max Cruz, all that good stuff. They even play some Nightrunner on there, which is one of my personal favorite synthwave artists. So yeah, I highly recommend you go check them out. Once again, that is Nightride.fm, your 24/7 synthwave radio. But just remember, everyone, just remember that this is not a sponsorship. Never was, never will be. This will always just be a thoughtful shill. The best kind of shill. Alright. Oh, man. Wootsies, they hurt. They do the big hurty. Shit situated. Bum ba da bum ba da dum. Yeah, we also got a little bit of a taste of Kratos' past. We need to head down here and put the skull of the sun.
Let the rage of the gods drive your blades, Kratos.
We might even also be able to get the Blades of Chaos max leveled this part as well. As we look at it here, yeah, we need 89 Hundo to level up. We're at 66. You want to insert the skull key in the lock. Oh, shit! Home dog, I get it. I need to ride the thing to get on the ladder. Let me. I like how a lot of these FMV cutscenes show, like, different variations of the Blades of Chaos, like, every time. Like, there it shows the Blades of Chaos at, like, level 1. There was the one cutscene where Kratos is introduced to the Oracle when we enter Athens. He sees that projection of her. And they show that, like, they show, like, a model of the Blades of Chaos, and I think it's the only time we see the Blades of Chaos in that particular, like, in that way. Which makes me think that, like, obviously these cutscenes were made, obviously, during, like, different stages of development, so shit changes over time, but I just think it's kind of interesting. Oh, fuck. Oh, shit. No, hold on. I think there's a brain freeze coming. Ah, fuck me. Ooh. Oh, all right. Come on. Come on. You can get through this. Ooh, boy. All right. That was mild. That was relatively mild, but still painful. Wait, are we doing the challenge of Hades? No. I think it's the challenge of Poseidon next. I think. I can't remember which challenge is next. Yeah, nope, it's Poseidon. Hey, so you can see the burning hellscape of Athens. Oh, puppy. He's a pupper. Hi, buddy. Oh. Oh, no. Oh. This is Cerberus. That was easy. I know there's, yeah, there's big dudes right there. I'm gonna fight them first. Come at me, bros. Ow. Come on now. Kick in the nuts. Punch in the nuts. Anyway. Point is, they're dead. Yeah, there's no point in kicking this. Dun, 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 dun. Oh shit! Damn it. How far back did it send me? Okay. We still good. I still have a chance to not fuck up. Can I do I have enough time to just run? Do I have to do the dodge roll? Okay, I have enough time to just run back. Oh, fuck me. I hate these guys. All right, give me them health orbs, boy. I need them. Yeah, it was one of my least favorite enemies in this game. All right, here we get this like cool little shot here. Hold on. Here, there'll be a secret. Hey, another Muse key. That's kind of weird. There's two. One of them is actually found in Challenge of Poseidon. I think it might change depending on whether or not you find the first one. Yeah, you get this cool shot here of Kronos. That's really cool. I like that. Fuck. I think that, yeah, it was a safe point right up here. Huh, weird. I think we are, yep, we are at enough. not the most favorite part coming up. Oh yeah, look at this. We got this nice red hue on the blades. Let's see. What the gods ask of me, no man could do. Not even Pandora's box is worth such a terrible price. There's a statue of Lord Poseidon written at the base of the door as a riddle. Sacrifice the ultimate to continue your quest. Wow. I picked up a handle and put it somewhere. Don't ask where. Hey, buddy. I'm sorry. I gotta do this to you.
Let me out of here. Free me. You must set me free. No further, please! Are you mad?
Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy, but this is for the greater good.
Not in that room. Oh, please. No. Gods on high, save me from this barbarian. Please, please. I'm begging you on your humanity. Don't do this. Please.
Bye-bye, sir. I'm gonna do a quick pick me up. Nope. Oh, hold on. Not before I get rid of these two dudes. Three. Oh, is the other guy dead? Okay, cool. Oh, no. There. So we got the Trident of Poseidon. Now we can breathe. We can breathe underwater, baby. Couldn't remember if there's anything on this side. No, there isn't. Yep.
Thank you.
Oh, you know what? Hold on. Oh, wait, there's another one. It is a statue of Lord Poseidon, ruler of the seas. Actually, do these have any meaning to them? No. I assume they're just muses. Ah, hello there, lady. Oh, hello there. Man, I almost forgot there was a right side. Oh shit. Alright, hold on. Ugh. I forget, does this lead into the Hades section? I think it does. Oh, wait, hold on now. Hold on, is this shit I never noticed? Ooh. I did not know this was here. Huh. I like that. Good. Go. Wait, I forget. Is there stuff up here that I could go to? Or is this just for show? I think this part up here is just for show. Okay. I'm tired. I forget there's a save point here. Hello there, lady. I don't remember. Is there anything behind Poseidon's big fucking head? No, there isn't. Oh, wait, hold on. There's some flavor text, though. Oh, actually, nothing interesting. God damn it. What does this read? Amphitrite, Poseidon's faithful wife, will forever watch over the curse, this cursed room. Only she knows the secret way out. And she's pointing directly at it. I actually just now noticed that. She technically is pointing directly at the secret way out. Nope, it's this one. Oh. How interesting. We are back here now. Alright, where is the thing with the thing on it? There it is. We have this amazing room right here. While the gods have hidden Pandora's box ball, they are not without mercy. Use these magical sands, gifts from the Olympians, to increase your chances of reaching your goal. Zeus bestows on you the gift of health. May your enemies tremble before your newly acquired strength. Zeus bestows on you the gift of experience. May your abilities grow beyond the reach of any mortal or beast. Prioritize next. I think maybe the Blade of Artemis. Come on, where's that staircase at? There it is. The giant statue boy. Wait. Another. Okay, nope, never mind. For some reason, I thought there was another hole to dive into. It is a massive wooden door. There is a lock on the door that has been carved in the shape of a minotaur. Another interesting camera angle. Hades challenges you to make blood sacrifices on his altars before you can pass. Do you accept? No! I want to see what's up there on the staircase. You are unable to go any further. It is too dark to see. Well, damn. Sure, I guess. Oh, whoops. Did that count? I did. Where's the other blood altar? Thank you. We're gonna hit these up right quick. Come on. That one always kind of fucks me up. Come on, dude. Oh my lord! There we go. MJ McFly, I think it was the raid of the party of four. How's it going, Bulldog? What are we doing? What are you playing? And most importantly, how has your night been? And Harley Reaper, thank you for the tier one resub for 21 months. Head pats the IRL. There's a shout out for you, Bulldog. for my followers at home, go follow Bulldog. Amazing, amazing person. Doing more Borderlands pre-sequel? Hell yeah. And I almost forgot. Hello everyone, I'm Beowulf the Bounty Hunter. Beowulf is my name and bounty hunting is my game. I hunt down the baddies of the Badlands and then I head back to my bunker hideout and I do this. And tonight we're continuing on with our God of War playthrough. We are currently in the middle of doing the Challenge of Hades, which is gonna, I know for a fact, is gonna climax with quite a boss fight that I honestly God can't wait to do. Oh shit, I got fucked up there. We have max leveled the Blades of Chaos and max leveled Poseidon's Rage. Our next order of business of leveling up is for the Blade of Artemis. Oh, hold on, yep, I'm gonna let that do its thing. Okay. Woo! Oh! Yeah, all of these games were a part of my childhood growing up. I loved God of War 1, and I very much loved God of War 2. Alright, you have the good sleep, Iro. What am I missing in this maze? This oh-so-beautiful maze of death. This door cannot be opened from here. Oh, yeah. I forgot I could move this. As that undead soldier comes from the wall.
Let the rage of the gods drive your blades, greatest.
Yeah, I hope pre-sequel went well for you, Bulldog. There we go. Open says me. This fun little part here. Oh wait, no. Actually, no, not yet. I'm misremembering. Mary, what are you doing, Cap? Falling on my chair like a heckin' doofus. Swim in the blood. Blood. Gallons of the stuff. Give them all that they can drink and it will never be enough. Thank you. Oh, yeah, I forgot it resets. The statue of Lord Hades, the ruler of the underworld. Oh, joy. I've seen Indiana Jones. I know how this goes. Except we're running towards the boulders. These ones are fiery. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. Woo! Remember there's anything here? There wasn't. Ha-ba-ba-ba-ba. Ho, ha, yeah. Trying to remember to not forget doors that may contain treasure. Come on, come on, come on! Oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, oh shit, ow. Come on. I'm trying to get this door. Oh, my lord. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, hold on. Hold on. Gotta wait. Gotta wait. Gotta wait. Gotta wait. Ha-ba-ba-ba. You see, we're supposed to go there. Because that's the right way. We don't want to go that way. Hold on, we gotta wait. See, the sucky thing is too, because we found the right way out of here. Because we found the right way out of here, the music just stops. It's kind of boring that does that. Oh, come on. And also, we would go down here, we get these. Eight dead ends, one way out. Will you find out before the flames of Hades consume you? We'll wait before the one in the middle goes down. Right, time to run. Ow. Now, time to play a game, but remember which one's the way out. Actually, I think that was it. Wait, hold on. I missed a door. How? How is that possible? Yeah, I think that's the way out right there, actually. Hold on. Take a little look-see. Nope. Third one down on the left. New Minotaurs! Oh, my lord. Harry, I quit it. Let it miss. What the fuck? What? Close to another level up. All right, nope, don't want to head there just yet. I think we're at the point now where all those blank chests are going to be giving us nothing but red orbs, because I think we've max leveled our health and magic up to as much as it can be for the remainder of the game. Oh, fuck me. Actually, I think he can literally cheese this first part. Hold on. There we go. Hey, who said anything about playing the level as intended? Damn it! I was trying to see if I could get away with that, but no. Game was like, no. Camera angle says fuck you. What the fuck was I supposed to do there? The game literally prevented me from fucking grabbing myself back up. That was some bullshit. Are you serious? I jumped back on the fucking beam. promise that there's one thing that'll give you anxiety. You gotta fucking balance your way across. Turn that. Uh-oh. Oh. Okay, do we head back up here? Nope. All right, here we go. Oh shit! Hey there, homeboy! Alright! Oh, whoops. Alright, I'm ready to dance. These QTEs being a little bit annoying. Oh shit. Bro, come on! Ugh. Getting real tired of your bullshit. Get fucked. You know, I'm gonna give you a treat for adding measure. Here, buddy, eat this. Oh shit. All right, Minotaur, it's 99, boy. Hey, thanks for getting the door, though. Give me the Morad orbs. Juicy. Jesus Christ, I forgot you need like 10,000 red orbs to level that fucking blade up. The already rotting carcass of the temple's minotaur hangs above you. I just want to know, how the hell was that thing fitting in here? I guess it could have been fitting in this, like, spiral cage, but, like, I don't know, man. My suspension of disbelief can only go so far. My second son, my last, has followed his brother to the Elysian fields. In my heart, I know I must continue the work of the gods, but they take so much, and last my soul begins to doubt. Pathos Verdes III. And there's no longer a loyal servant of the gods on the end of that. All right, here, buddy, I need your head too. That's another one of my favorite abilities. Also, I gotta say, I think I like Hades' design more in this game than the others. We need 4,500 to level those up. am, boy. Can I push it the other way? No. Hell, I think the next room is the one we need to go to anyway. We shall see. Nope. All that's left to do now is to turn the statue.
Thank you.
Yes, now we've raised that statue. We are gonna head up because there's like one extra cutscene I wanna get to before I end things off.
Your progress is impressive, Kratos. But be warned. Once you ascend to the upper levels of the temple, you will not be able to return without Pandora's box.
That is basically the game telling us, hey, this is a point of no return. Make sure you got everything you need before you head up there.
As Kratos rose through the massive temple constructed to guard Pandora's box, he realized it was a monument not only to the gods of Olympus, but to the madness of the warlord who had designed it. He'd conquered the lower floors of Pandora's temple, but what lay in wait above would test even the greatest warlord.
Oh shit. These guys are a little annoying. Oh, but these are the guys in that challenge in the challenge of the gods I was telling you guys about. I think it was like last part or the part before. The challenge that required you to kill enemies in midair to like raise a platform up. Yeah, it was these guys you had to fight. I can't remember what they're called though. I think there's a bestiary in the game.
Kratos had been in service to the gods long enough to know the harpy had been sent as a warning, a reminder from his former master of the decision that had cost Kratos everything. Had it been that long since he'd almost met his end at the hands of the barbarians, that long since he'd traded everything to save himself?
Ares!
The sky split apart. And the god of war stepped through. Descending from Olympus, he saw the makings of a god in a mere mortal. Ares would save Kratos. He would turn him into the perfect warrior, his servant on Earth. Only a simple pledge of loyalty was required.
My life is yours, Ares. From this day, I shall carry forth your will.
And his fate was sealed. As promised, Ares rescued his new disciple, bringing forth the power of a god, destroying those who would slaughter Kratos and his men. As for Kratos, no mere sword and shield would befit the newest servant of the god of war. The
blades of chaos, forged in the foulest depths of Hades. Once attached, the chains remained so, chained and seared to the flesh, a part of the bearer's body, a permanent reminder of Kratos' pledge. In return, ultimate power. The rage of Ares exploded from within. But soon, he would learn the true cost of such power. A cost too high, even for Kratos to pay.
Wretched beast! I know who it is you serve!
Return to your master! Tell the god of war I am his no longer. Tell him he is not safe while I walk the earth. I will find Pandora's box.
And I will use it to see him tremble and fall before me.
Yeah. Crazy shit! Shit that Kratos, will forever regret. Maybe death isn't so bad at the hands of a barbarian. Yeah, it's at this point where the game literally starts showering us in red orbs, because it's like, bro, if you're not like upgrading your weapons at this point, what are you doing? Which, nope, not yet. What does this read? The cliffs of madness lie before you. In my grieving, I fear I may have designed a maze with no true way out. If I'm right, may the cruel, uncaring gods show you the way. Pathos Verdes III, once a loyal subject of the gods. Yeah, we don't really have that much left. We got the Cliffs of Madness, and then we got, like, one other thing. We might have, like, two parts left on this. I gotta say, streaming this game has made me realize how short this game actually is. But it's fine. Even after we do this, I'm doing the other games. Like, I'm gonna do God of War 2 after this one. Although, I'm not sure. I think, after I do this, I might do the PSP games. So, after this, we'll do Chains of Olympus, which actually takes place before God of War 1, but shush. But then Ghost of Sparta, which takes place before God of War 2, and after God of War 1, and arguably has the best story out of all the classic games. That's just me, though. So we'll probably hit up the PSP games first before we do God of War 2, and then we'll do God of War 3, which, obviously, in case you guys didn't notice by the thing on the top left every time I saved, I am using an emulator for all these games. The only game I don't have to emulate is God of War 3, because I own that on PS4. And that's easy to stream, so... hell yeah. Yeah, like that. But in the meanwhile, let us see. Ah! Ooh, it's up to raid. My back is killing me! Alright. Boop. I see a Leshy on right now. Leshy the Dwarf. Who is currently playing Pacific Drive. Which I've heard pretty good things about. Let's get this raid set up. Just remember, everyone, if you guys enjoyed what you have seen and you haven't already, don't forget to give me a follow over here. Don't forget to give me a follow over here on Twitch. Turn on notifications for a number to go live. Star links below to find me with Instagram and Twitter and Blue Sky and Threads to get any and all stream updates and announcements that I may have. There's also a link to my YouTube channel that you can subscribe to, because that's where I post the VODs for the Mountain Blade Monday series, as well as the main playthroughs I do for the channel. And shorts, whenever I get shorts. So yeah, rest of this week, we got more Van Helsing on Thursday. We have possibly the finale of Mass Effect on Friday. Because we're doing Vermeier. We're doing the rest of Vermeier on Friday. And after that, I hear there's like one more thing before the end of the game. And that's basically it. We have that. And yeah, me and Pei are shooting for Saturday to pick up the Darksiders Genesis playthrough. So yeah, that's finally, that should finally be getting picked up, again this week. I know it's been a few weeks since the last part, but we're trying to make it work. This has been difficult, but let me get this right for Leshy. And make sure to go let Leshy know that the bounty hunter has arrived on their doorstep. And in the meanwhile, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you all have a terrific Tuesday night, evening, morning, whatever the case may be. And I will see you guys on Thursday for the next part of Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing. Have a good night, everyone, and see ya.